I'm Micah, and today we're gonna go through Fog of War. It is a two to four player game made by Gavin Birnbaum, and he made his own gaming company called Cubico Games, and he is based in London, UK. So let's get right into it. Fog of War is a hidden information tank game. In Fog of War, your goal is to get one of your tanks to the opponent's base, and the moment you do that, you win. It's slightly different for 3 and 4 players, but you get the idea. Each person has 7 tanks, and they all have a number, a power, of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7, and your opponents are unable to see them based upon how you put them. One of the neatest mechanics of this game is the optimal range ammunition technology, where if your tank shoots from the exact number of spaces away for its power to be a 1, it can destroy a 5, 6, or 7 powered tank. So even a 1 powered tank can kill a 7 powered tank when it's right next to it. Or your 4 power tank could shoot 4 spaces away at a 5, 6, or 7 and it would die. Which also, by the way, makes your 4 powered tank one of the strongest tanks in the game because it can only be destroyed by a 5, 6, or 7. So that's a little bit about that. Let's go real quickly and show you how the game sets up for 2, 3, or 4 players. This is the setup for a 2-player game. As you'll see, you just have a straight-on conquest towards your opponent's base. And then for a 3-player game, we look for the 3s and we rotate accordingly. This is the setup for a 3-player game. And in the 3-player game, your objective is to get to anybody else's base but yours. And then in the 4-player game, and here we have the setup for a 4-player game. And in the 4-player game, the blue team would have to get one of their tanks to the opponent's base directly opposite them, which would be the green, and the black would have to get to the opponent's base directly opposite them, which is the red. But they can all be attacking each other, but you have to worry about, am I helping my opponents too much, or am I trying to keep my own tanks alive? So it makes it for a very interesting 4-player game. Now, real quick, let's talk about some of the mechanics for how you move and destroy tanks. On any given turn, you can look at any of your tanks and find out what number it is and then place it back in the position it was at. And then you get 2 actions in each turn, and they can both be the same action if you want to, but there are 4 different actions you can do. The first action is to move a tank 1 space in the direction that it is facing, or move it backwards 1 space in the direction that it is facing. The second thing you can do is turn a tank 1 face of the hexagon for 1 action, or back 1 face, and that way. The third thing you can do is you can rotate the tank's turret any number of faces for 1 action point. And then the final thing you can do is fire your tank and attack at another tank that it is currently facing. Attacks in this game work with a regular line of sight principle, where if there is a tank in front of another tank, you cannot shoot through it to get to the one behind it, and it can only hit the things that are right in front of it. So when you fire an attack at a tank, you would declare what number your tank is, so a 6, and then as it fires, it has a 6 directly next to it, and then it goes down in its power as it moves forward. So 6, 5, 4, this is an attack with a 3 power. So then your opponent would look at his tank and it is a 2. He doesn't have to tell you that. As long as your 3 beats it, he just takes it away and you don't know what level of power that tank was. But if his tank were, for example, a 3, he would say to you without anybody else knowing, he would show you that it was a 3 and he would put it back and it would survive the attack, because to kill a tank, you actually have to have more power than the actual number, so ties survive. Always remember that the optimal range ammunition technology allows a smaller tank to destroy one of the 5, 6, or 7s if they attack at the right range. So in this instance, I have replaced my tank with a 4 right here, and this tank, it is attacking the tank right here at 4, 3, 2, and 1, so it's optimal range, and the opponent has a 6. So that would actually kill the 6. And again, if it dies, they don't have to tell you what it is, they just take it off. And you don't know whether you've killed the 5, the 6, or the 7, but you know that you've gotten rid of one of their powerful tanks. If you ever get confused about how the attacks work, this game comes with a nifty little chart that shows exactly how they work and how the powers go down and what can actually destroy what. And that really helps a lot. And then just to reiterate, the game is a very simple objective of just getting your tank onto the opponent's base, and as soon as you accomplish that, the game is over. So it doesn't matter if you've killed any tanks or if they've killed all of yours but one, even the smallest tank can win you the game if you can position it right and get it to your opponent's base in Fog of War. We hope you've enjoyed this how to play video of Fog of War by Gavin Birnbaum of Cubico Games. If you are interested in buying it, the only way to get it is to contact him at cubico.games@outlook.com. And we hope that you'll join us for our other videos here on the Board Game Network. Thanks for coming.